Taproot is the latest upgrade to Bitcoin and it was just released. It is the biggest upgrade in 4 years and it brings some massive changes that will solidify Bitcoin's place as the number one cryptocurrency. If you want to learn more, smash that like button and keep watching. First of all, Taproot is a soft fork. If you don't know what a fork is, well, it happens at a point where the blockchain is copied and modified, essentially creating two different versions of the blockchain. This actually applies to all software and often happens in non-blockchain open source projects. Now, a soft fork means that the new version is backwards compatible, meaning that the non-upgraded blockchain nodes can still communicate with the upgraded ones. In comparison, hard forks remove that ability, so nodes that do not upgrade cannot participate in the new blockchain. In this case, the soft fork will enable the Bitcoin network to continue working without breaking anything and gives plenty of time for all the nodes to gradually update. Also, the soft fork only becomes active when the majority of the miners and nodes upgrade to the new version, which essentially becomes the release date. In this case, that was Sunday, the 14th of November 2021, when 90% of miners locked in the Taproot update. So, what does Taproot bring to the table? Well, Taproot will essentially improve three aspects of Bitcoin: scalability, privacy, cost, which altogether will massively improve Bitcoin's smart contract functionality. Let's start with scalability. The Taproot upgrade enables the full functionality of the Lightning Network in Bitcoin. If you haven't heard of the Lightning Network, it is essentially a layer 2 payment protocol that is layered on top of blockchain-based currencies, like Bitcoin. It was first used in 2017 with Litecoin to make microscopic payments that Bitcoin could not support. Then, in January of 2019, the Lightning Network was tested in a very promotional way, where small networks were sent from one person to the next, with each participant adding 10,000 satoshis, which was about $0.34 at the time. It did serve to show that you could make fast, low-cost payments with Bitcoin, but the functionality was still not fully developed. Taproot will enable Bitcoin to take full advantage of the Lightning Network, and it will do that in a specific way. Essentially, Taproot aggregates all of the keys and or multi-signatures that Bitcoin uses to perform transactions into a single dataset. Taproot achieves that by using something known as a Schnorr signature, which, to put it simple, allows you to combine multiple keys and signatures into one unique Schnorr signature. Of course, this is a very simple explanation of what it does, but the main takeaway is that it helps to reduce the Bitcoin block space and therefore improve scalability. Now, the second benefit of Bitcoin's Taproot upgrade is, like I mentioned before, privacy. Up until now, Bitcoin used P2SH or pay to script hash. If you don't know what a hash is, it's essentially the output of a hashing function, which takes a variable length input and returns an encrypted result of a fixed length. If you provide the same inputs to hashing functions, the output will always be the same. But most importantly, hashing functions are one-way functions, which means that you cannot revert or decrypt the hash to find out the inputs. This is very private, but currently Bitcoin reveals all of these hashes when completing a contract, so essentially we can see which wallets participated in that contract. Plus, it also bloats the block space, which makes it harder to scale contracts on the Bitcoin network. Now, Taproot fixes that by introducing MAST, or Merkleized Abstract Syntax Trees. MAST is extremely technical, so let's just say that it allows multiple people to agree on a condition, which is then turned into a single, unique Schnorr signature. Essentially, it takes all of these hashes that we just talked about and puts them into a single signature. This signature does not even reveal to the Bitcoin network that there was a contract used, therefore hiding all the signatures, address owners, and the type of transaction. Finally, Taproot improves Bitcoin's cost by reducing fees. The reduction in block space that we've just talked about essentially leads to lower fees for the larger, more complex transactions done using Bitcoin. Again, this is achieved using the Schnorr signatures and MAST, and will benefit the Lightning Network along with other complex wallets and contracts on the Bitcoin network. This will probably not have a big impact on simple transactions, so if you're just using Bitcoin as a long-term hold and a store of value, it will probably not affect your transaction fees that much. However, what is really important about this upgrade is that, in addition to all the other benefits, Taproot also lays the foundation for important future updates of Bitcoin by adding Schnorr signatures and MAST. These features are extremely powerful and can be used to make Bitcoin even more scalable, even more private, and even cheaper to use. This upgrade is an important milestone and one of the reasons why I continue buying a little bit of Bitcoin every single month. But that's just me. What do you think about Taproot? Are you a fan of the new upgrade? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share the video with anyone who may be interested. Thanks for watching and keep learning.